friends, this is Chandan Bhola and you are watching Bhola MedTech. So today what we are going to discuss is the fixed type caliper and the floating type caliper. These are the diagrams of the fixed and the floating type caliper. अगर आप ये वीडियो हिंदी में देखना चाहते हैं तो मैं आज ही शाम को इस वीडियो को हिंदी में भी पब्लिश करूंगा, आप इस वीडियो को जब भी देख सकते हैं. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एलैबोरेटिंग द डायग्राम ऑफ दिस फिक्स टाइप कैलिपर. नाउ दिस इज द दिस ब्लू लाइन पार्ट इज द कैलिपर बॉडी. देन दिस इज द कैविटी फॉर द प्रेशर स्क्रू टू कम इनसाइड दिस कैलिपर. दीज आर द ब्रेक पैड्स दैट हैज पोर्शन एंड दीज आर द ब्रेक पिस्टन एंड दिस इज द कैविटी फॉर द ब्रेक पिस्टन टू मूव. And this is the brake disc. So this is the complete diagram. And coming to the top view of this fixed type caliper, this is the cavity. This is the this is the caliper body. This is the disc brake. These are the pads and these are the pistons. And this is the inlet for the pressurized fluid. Now coming to the diagram of the floating type caliper. The diagram is slightly similar, but there is only one piston and only on the one side. Now this is the brake piston, this is the brake pad, this is the caliper body, this is the cavity for the pressure fluid to come in, this is the another pad that is directly mounted on the body of the caliper, and this is the top view of the caliper. Now coming to the top view, this is the inlet for the pressurized fluid and there are some cavities, and after that there is the cavity of the piston so that piston can move inside, and these are the pad and this is the disc. And these are the sliding bars on which this whole floating type caliper will move. So coming to the functioning of the fixed type caliper first. Now when the pressurized fluid from the tender master cylinder, or it may be a master cylinder, it comes through this screw that has some cavity inside which, through which the pressurized fluid comes inside these cavities, and when these pressurized fluid move inside this cavity and come to the piston cavity, now the pressurized fluid and the area of the piston causes a force, that is pressure into the area of the piston. Now this force will be applicable on this brake pad, and due to the force this piston will move in the axial direction towards the disc. Now both of the piston will be moving towards the direction of the disc brake. Now when these brake pads come in contact with the disc brake, they are going to apply some force on this disc brake. The disc brake is mounted on the wheel which is moving at the speed of the wheel. Now when they come in contact with the disc, then what happens is when the force applied by this piston is F and the coefficient of friction between the brake pad and the disc is mu, so the mu F will be the force that is going to retard the disc, the rotating disc, and this is the cause of the retardation of disc. Now when the disc retarded, since it is connected to the wheel, so the wheel retarded and hence your vehicle retarded. So coming to the floating type caliper, now the basic difference between them is in this fixed type caliper both pistons move toward the disc, but in this type of the caliper only one piston moves towards this. When the pressure fluid comes through this, the piston actuates. Now when the piston comes in contact with this disc and hence it cannot actuate further, then what happens is it applies the opposite force on this caliper, due to which the caliper moves in the opposite direction, and hence this brake pad come in contact with the disc. So when both of the piston comes in contact with this, again this concept is applied over here, and due to which the disc retarded and hence the vehicle retarded. There are several advantages and disadvantages of both of these calipers. First of all, taking the disadvantages, the fixed type caliper is somewhat complicated because there are two pistons that are going to actuate, so it is somewhat complicated in designing this. There are the cavity, more cavity is required in these fixed type caliper, so it is difficult to manufacture them. It is somewhat complicated to manufacture them, so that's why it is costly also. And due to the servicing cost, because at the time of service you need to take out both of the piston, then cleaning all this, so this increases the service cost also. And you can see the space taken by this fixed type caliper is more. So now coming to the disadvantage of the floating type caliper, it takes less force because only one piston is actuating, so less force is there. It needs ABS because taking to the verge of the non-locking tires, it is difficult in this case. So we need ABS. Now the assembly is movable. So before designing everything, you just don't need to give it a perfect space, but you also have to consider the space it take after the movement. Now coming to the advantages of both of these calipers. This fixed step caliper is high performable because both of the piston are actuating and hence it can apply more squeezing power. So this is more efficient, more performable fixed step calipers. Now coming to the floating type calipers, these are cheap because they don't need higher amount of manufacturing cost. Now coming to the service, it is quite easier to take out one piston with respect to the two piston, taking out the two piston, then cleaning all that. Now coming to the space, because it is quietly small, so it is compact structure. Now I think this is all about what I can explain up to you in the calipers. If you still have any doubts and any queries, you can please ask me in the comment section below. If you have any questions regarding my channel or for the Sunday video, you can please give me the questions in the comment section below. If you like this video, please share it to your friends so that I can connect to them also. If you didn't subscribe my channel yet, please subscribe it at this moment. And thanks a lot guys for watching my videos. Please keep watching, keep sharing and keep supporting guys. Thanks a lot.